And this tape was called How to Understand Bukhari and Muslim. It's an evil tape, ya ikhwan. I went through the tape and I was shocked by the statements, the evil statements he says about Shaykh al-Albani, rahmahullah. He says Shaykh al-Albani is more damaging than Ibn Hazm, more dangerous than Ibn Hazm, regarding making hadith da'if in Sahih Muslim. First of all, Shaykh al-Albani, rahmahullah, does not make da'if hadith in Sahih Muslim. What Shaykh al-Albani did was research, and he was in line with some of the scholars of hadith in the past, like Nisa'i, Dharqutni, and Ibn Hajar, regarding certain narrators in Bukhari, in Sahih Muslim. For example, Abu Zubair. Abu Zubair is one of the narrators in Muslim, who has a defect when he narrates hadith, when it's an'ana, when it's, for example, on the authority of. Okay? So, Shaykh al-Albani looked at these hadith, and he finds supporting narrations for these hadith. But this point was not mentioned by Zarabozo. He did not say that Shaykh al-Albani found supporting narrations for these hadith. Thereby, Shaykh al-Albani defending Imam Muslim and his Sahih, rather than saying he attacked Sahih Muslim. So he's ignorant of in the course of tafsir. He's ignorant in Ilm al-Hadith. And he's speaking about the Alam al-Rabbani of Ilm al-Hadith. So this is one example, but it's a long story. Read it inshallah when you get to it. Another third point is issues of methodology. He attacked Shaykh al-Albani, this is in his website. You go to Yahoo, you type Zarabozo, fake jihad. You see one of the things that comes up is establishing Islamic State by fighting. Establishing Islamic State by fighting. And this is manhaj of Zarabozo. The same as the Takfiris or the same as the jihad, those who want to cause demonstrations against the Muslim government. Just like what happened in Algeria. And still they are continuing to fight and the bloodshed is continuing because they did not go to the ulama, the elder scholars. So he says the statement of Al-Albani rahimahullah, أقيموا دولة الإسلام أقيموا دولة الإسلام في قلوبكم تقم في أرضكم. This is a very naive way of thinking. And this kind of sarcasm, ya ikhwan, against the ulama, and also this ignorance, the way he's speaking, he says this is a naive way of thinking. Shaykh al-Albani, when he rahimahullah, said this point, he explained it, what he means. أقيموا دولة الإسلام في قلوبكم تقم. Establish the Islamic State in your heart, it will be established in the land. He explained it. Tawheed, return to Tawheed, return to practicing your deed. Hadith of in Sahih Abi Dawud. إذا تباعتم بالعينة وتمسكتم بأنب البقر ورضيتم بالزرع وتركتم الجهاد في سبيل الله صمت الله عليكم ذلة لا ينزع عنكم حتى ترجع للدين إلى دينكم. If you deal with all these dunya matters and you leave jihad, then Allah سبحانه وتعالى will permit your humiliation and he will not remove it from you until you return to your deen. This is how Shaykh al-Albani explained it. And you can find this explanation with the statements of Shaykh al-Saymin regarding this statement. Shaykh al-Saymin said, rahimahullah, regarding this particular statement of Shaykh al-Albani, he said this is a good statement. Shaykh Ibn Baz, rahimahullah, regarding this whole statement on this issue, he said, أخونا الفاضل Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah, our companion, the Honorable Shaykh, has reached the truth regarding his statement, regarding this. I asked Shaykh Muqbil, rahimahullah, just before he passed away in Jeddah, we went to see him while he was in hospital. He was lying down, and we managed to ask him about this statement of Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah. I mentioned this statement, and Shaykh Muqbil said, this is a correct statement. This is a correct statement. And in fact, Shaykh al-Albani explained that this statement was actually from one of the heads of the Ikhwan Muslimin. And Shaykh al-Albani said it would have been better if they stuck to it. It would be better if they stuck to it. One of the heads of the Ikhwan Muslimin, Hassan al-Hudaybi, who was basically came after Hassan al-Banna, and he mentioned this statement, but they did not stick to it. They did not stick to it, Islamic statement in their own self. So what you find is from Shaykh al-Albani, Zarabozo, is going against the four kibar ulama in issues of manhaj. In issues of ilm al-hadith, he's going against Shaykh al-Albani and his scholars. In issues of usul tafsir, he's going against them, and he writes a book on tafsir. And all these statements, and there are many more in his tapes. If you look at his recent book also, for example, his one on the Hadith of Jibreel, and I hope inshallah the brothers will know about these things, because it's very important. On the Hadith of Jibreel, look in there. All the aspects of Iman and Amal, he quotes from Zahirat al-Irja' from Safar al-Hawali, who has been refuted. This is his manhaj. He must be careful from this person and from his methodology, and there's so much to say. I will leave the rest inshallah for your research. You go inshallah to the website and check it. And I'll end. One thing is, we have to look at the link of who these people are with and who are with them. And we keep away from that. عرفت الشر لا لشري ولكن لتوقيه. ومن لم يعرف الخير من الشر يقع فيه. Whoever, I have known the evil, not because of the evil, but to keep away from it. And whoever does not know the good from the bad will fall into it. And this is a statement of Hudayfa from Yemen. He told that he warned us about, that people used to ask about the good, I used to ask about the evil, fearing that I will fall into it. We must know about the evil. We must don't just say, oh, backbite you brothers, backbite you. We must know about the evil, ya ikhwan. Especially those in this country where you are dealing with them. So Jamaluddin al-Zarabozo has evil methodology. And he goes against the ulama al-kibar. And he speaks ill of the, and this has been known. But when you research, you see, you bring up so many things from this person. And look at the people who follow him. Yasir Qadi, for example, who mentions in his beginning of his introduction of principles of tafsir, or principles of understanding the Quran, he mentions about, I thank my Sheikh Zarabozo. And we know about his link with, and look at the people who hang around with him. Yasir Qadi was recently invited to Masjid Tawheed, where he did the conference there with Sayyid Hassan and Abu Aliya, and did also a conference in Houston with Abu Aliya. Look at their link. And we stick to the ulama, let them stick to the shuhada.